Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on making modals with Discord PY. So to demonstrate, I can use the modal slash command, modal, and it generates a modal. It says, should you subscribe to Digiwind? And then this is a placeholder of yes. And we can say maybe yes or no, right? You can decide. I click submit and it sends the result in the channel. So to use modals to create them, you're gonna need to have Discord PY version 2.0. So you can install from GitHub with this. I'll leave this information in the description as well, but you'll need 2.0. So now let's jump into the code. Okay, so we're gonna need to import a couple things. We're gonna need to import Discord UI from Discord and app commands, as well as date time. So let's do that now. Okay, so we need to import Discord for Discord PY, obviously, and then we need UI and app commands. So app commands is for our slash commands, and UI is for our modal, and we need date time for our embed. Okay, so I'm going to subclass our client. I'm going to copy some code from our GitHub that from our previous video. So basically what we have here is that we subclass our client, and we have a variable synced, which is false. So we do this to make sure that the bot doesn't sync the commands more than once, otherwise we'll be rate limited by Discord. And whenever we're on ready, we're going to wait until ready, and then we're going to sync. So basically, we're going to sync our tree for a specific guild ID. So you can leave this blank if it's global, and global registration across slash commands can take 1 to 24 hours. So this is for our slash commands, and then we set sync to true, and then we print we have logged in. So our client can be client, which is this class here. And then tree is our app commands, our command tree. And then this is our slash command. So essentially what I can do here is I can basically copy this and we're gonna adapt it for modals. So I'm going to add it. So we wanna specify a guild ID here. Okay, so this is our testing server ID. You can paste it here as well. And what we wanna do here is that we want to change this command from tester to modal. Say this can be an example modal. And change this to modal. So we don't want this, right? So we want a, I'm going to put it here for now, but we want a modal. So basically, we need to create a class. And inside of our class, we're going to have the modal. And we're also going to have like inputs, so text input. So let's create that now. Okay, so what we have here is our class, and then we have it as UI.modal. I'll show you that documentation. Let's see, let's go to modal. So basically what we have here is, here's the example. So we can have the modal, the title, right? And then we can have like timeout, custom ID, etc. We can, and then we have async on submit, and we're gonna need text input for our inputs. So let's look at that now. So basically you can have label, the style. So your style can be like short or paragraph, whether it's like one line or three lines. Placeholder, so what you want the text to display, and default, which is like text that's already there. So whenever the user opens the modal, that text will already be there. Whether or not the text input is required, and the minimum and maximum length. So by default, your maximum length is, I believe, 4,000 characters, then the row. So by default, it depends. It's the order that you specify your input. Now let's implement this. Okay, so my title will be example modal, and I can add different inputs. So for example, let's just, for simplicity's sake, let's just add one input. We'll just call it, I don't know, answer. So we want UI.textInput, and then we can have a label, a style, custom ID, placeholder, default, required, minimum length, maximum length, and which row. So let's create a label first. Let's just call it, should you subscribe to Digiwind? And let's have our style as short, because we probably only need a yes or no response. And then we have can have long, paragraph, or short. And we can just do short. Long and paragraph, if I remember correctly, are the same. You can have either one line or three lines. For this example, we only need short. Then we can add a placeholder. placeholder. So we can like specify a placeholder here. Let's just say yes, maybe, right? And we can have a default text here. So yes, no. So this is, will be text that's already there. And placeholder is just sort of like this, like a sort of example answer or recommended answer. And then we can say like that it's required. Require equals true or false. Let's just have it true for now. And we can also have these other inputs if you want, like max, minimum length, and so on. So let's just try max length of, I'm just trying everything here, max length of say 3, because yes is only 3 characters long. And let's work on our callback. So we want to use async def onSubmit. Yeah, async def onSubmit, not callback. Okay, and we have self interaction. And we don't need this. We can basically do, we can create an embed. Okay, so we can create an embed, discord.embed title, self.title. So this will get this. So it should be called example modal, as it was in our example. See example modal. We can have our description be, say, a question and the response. So you want to be careful with this, because if you don't specify this max length lower than like around 4,000, make sure your embed is either split up into multiple embeds or you shorten the response. Otherwise, it won't send your embed, because your embed can only be like, I think it was like 6,000 or so characters. So you need to make sure you watch out for that. But in our case, we only have one input, so we should be fine. So let's have this variable's label and its response. Okay, so this should be discord.interaction, and we have our answer label. So this here should you subscribe to Digiwind, bolden, and then our new line will be this answer. And that's basically it for our description. If you want to do this like for more inputs, you could probably do like fields maybe, but you have to watch your character limit. And you can have up to 5 text inputs. This is a Discord limitation. And we can finish our embed now. Okay, now we can set the author to the person who responded. So embed.setAuthor. Okay, so our name will be interaction.user. Our icon URL should be interaction.user.displayAvatar. No, useravatar, sorry. And now we can send the embed. Okay, so now we're finished with our modal. We can now work on our slash command. So instead of interaction.responseSendMessage, we can use interaction.sendModal. And there we have it. So essentially what we have here is that we have the name as modal, an example modal, and then we respond with a modal, and then it'll just appear. So we can run this with a token. Let's go to our developer portal and make sure you keep this safe. I'll have this regenerated by the time you see this video. Okay, now let's run our code. Okay, let's run Python 3 modal example.py. And let's wait for it to tell us that we have logged in. Okay, we've logged in. Let's go to Discord. And let's run modal again. Uh-oh, looks like something went wrong. Let's take a look at what happened. Uh-oh, okay, we have an error here. So it says invalid form body, because we set our max length to 3 and our default is 6 characters. So we need to fix that. So we can just do 6, and let's restart the bot. If we run modal, there we go. Okay, so it says, should you subscribe to Digiwind? And I'm typing, not sure if you can tell, but I'm typing, and it does not allow me to go beyond the 6 limit, character limit. And as you can see here, it says must be between 0 and 6 in length, and it says yes. So okay, so that's not entirely true. It has to be above 0. So it says our placeholder is yes. And then if we like say, let's say maybe, right? Then if we submit, it says that, that example modal, should you subscribe to Digiwind? Maybe. And then the author is me. So it's my avatar and my username and discriminator. So if you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. And I hope you enjoyed watching. Thanks for watching.